Let's look at this question. Johnny has 63 shirts in his cupboard. The shirts type of neck can be one of the following four types: polo, Henley, V-neck, or round neck. He has bought these shirts at one of the four prices: 300, 400, 500, and 600. Okay. The number of Henley shirts is equal to the number of round neck shirts, which is 50% more than number of polo shirts, and the number of V-neck shirts is 25% more than that of polo shirts. Okay, so hero of the storyline is polo shirts. So if polo shirts are X, but I need 25% more and 50% more. So let this be 4X. So V-neck shirts would be 5X. And Henley shirts and round neck shirts would be 6X and 6X. Altogether, I will get 21X. And this 21X is equal to 63 given in the beginning of the question itself. Which means there are 12 polo shirts, 15 V-neck shirts, 18 Henley shirts, and 18 round neck shirts. Okay. Next point. The number of shirts priced at 500 is 3 more than the number of shirts priced at 300, as well as the number of shirts priced at 600. The number of shirts priced at 400 is twice the number of shirts priced at 300. Okay. So 300 and 600 are equal. Let's call them Y and Y. Shirts priced at 500 is Y plus 3, and shirts priced at 400 is 2Y. You add these up, you get 5Y plus 3. And if 5Y plus 3 is equal to 63, Y is equal to 12. So you have 12 shirts of this variant, 12 shirts of this variant, 15 of this, and 24 of this. We have this information also. So the best way to represent this data now would be a grid. I have polo, V-neck, Henley, and round neck. I have 300, 400, 500, and 600 as prices of the shirts. Let us record it. We also know polo is 12, V-neck is 15, Henley is 18, round neck is 18, 300 is 12, 400 is 24, 500 is 15, 600 is 12. Okay, all this info we know. Next is, he has neither a polo shirt. Let me also draw lines, it is easier to make marks then. He has neither a polo shirt priced at 300, so nothing here, nor a V-neck shirt priced at 600. V-neck shirt at 600, not present. Apart from this, then every combination of type of neck and price is a positive multiple of 3. Okay, so everywhere we need multiples of 3. Fine. Last point is, he has 6 polo shirts that are priced at 600. 6 polo shirts that are priced at 600. So I have 6 shirts here. And if I have 6 shirts here, see this. This row is supposed to have all numbers in multiples of 3. 6 is already used up. So this will be 3 and 3. This column is also supposed to have all multiples of 3. 6 is used up. So this will be 3 and 3. Wonderful. 6 V-neck shirts are priced at 500. 6 V-neck shirts are priced at 500. Okay. Now that I have this, can I also infer this now? See, I have 3 here, 6 here for column 500. 3, 6. So this will be 3. This will be 3. This is also done. Okay. For V-neck, it will be either 6 or 3 here. Okay. I don't know where is what, so I will take care of it later. This is guaranteed info that I have. Any other piece of guaranteed info? No, this is the guaranteed info that I have. Let us look at the individual questions. What are the number of shirts with Johnny that are either Henley or priced at 500? Now see, shirts with him are 18 and 15, but there is an overlap of 3. So 18 plus 15 minus 3 should be the answer. 18 plus 15 is 33 minus 3. Answer here should be 30. Next question. If Johnny gave all the round neck shirts priced at 300 to his servant. Okay, all these shirts are given to his servant. Then the number of shirts priced at 300 left with him is If he is giving all of them, the distribution here will be 633. The distribution here will be 633. I don't know where would be 6, where would be 3, but 633. So either 6 shots are going away or 3 shots are going away. Either 6 shots are going away or 3 shots are going away. In any case, can you see? You don't know the precise number of shots he is giving away. So you will not reach a precise number as an answer. The answer would be between two choices. And there is just one choice that says either 6 or 9. That will be option D. You can also justify 6 or 9 by saying either 6 shots are here or 3 shots are here. From 12, when you remove 6, you are left with 6. When you remove 3, you are left with 9. So answer will definitely be 6 or 9. This is wonderful. Seventh question. The number of Henley shirts with Johnny that are priced at 400 is. Henley shirts with Johnny priced at 400. This number. We don't know what this number is. Therefore, answer will be cannot be determined. Cannot answer this. Last question. If Johnny has 6 round neck shirts. 6 round neck shirts priced at 400. Okay. This is 6 now. If this is 6. 3, 3, 6. I have 12 so far, so this will be 6. If this is 6, so this will be 3 and this will be 3. Which means this will be 6 and this will be 9. I have all the numbers now. I am also not averse to writing it down because it is the last question of the set. Then how many V-neck are there with him priced at 300? V-neck priced at 300. V-neck priced at 300 would be 3 shirts. So answer to the question is option A.